Good evening, and welcome to all of you here as we complete 1 year and look forward to another year of grace. Let's begin in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you. Today is the feast of the Holy Family, Jesus, Mary, and Joseph. Reminder to us that we are members of a great family, the human family, a great family of faith, the church, and our own families from which we come. How fortunate we are to be able to travel through life with all these friends and neighbors, brothers and sisters. Let's pause a moment as we begin. At the back of the book, the green ribbon here. Lord Jesus, you are mighty God and Prince of Peace. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you are Son of God and Son of Mary. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you are Word made flesh and splendor of the Father. Lord, have mercy. The Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, bring us to everlasting life. Join us now in a hymn of praise and glory. Let us pray. O God, who are pleased to give us the shining example of the Holy Family, graciously grant that we may imitate them in the practice of virtues of family life, in the bonds of charity, and so in the joy of your house, delight one day in eternal rewards. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. a proclamation from the book of Sirach. The Lord honors a father above his children, and he confirms a mother's right over her children. Whoever honors their father atones for sins and gains preservation from them. When they pray, they will be heard. Whoever respects their mother is like one who lays up a treasure. The person who honors their parents will have joy in their own children, and when they pray, they will be heard. Whoever respects their father will have a long life, and whoever honors their mother obeys the law. My children, help your parents in their old age, and do not grieve them as long as they live. Even if their minds fail, be patient with them. Because you have all your faculties, do not despise them all the days of their lives. For kindness to your parents will not be forgotten and will be credited you against your sins. A house raised in justice. The word of the Lord.
Thank you. proclamation from the letter of St. Paul to the Colossians. My brothers and sisters, as God's chosen ones, holy and beloved, clothe yourselves with compassion, kindness, humility, meekness, and patience. Bear with one another, and if anyone has a complaint against another, forgive each other just as the Lord has forgiven you. So you also must forgive. Above all, clothe yourselves with love, which binds everything together in perfect harmony. And let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts, to which indeed you were called in one body. And be thankful. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly. Teach and admonish one another in all wisdom, and with gratitude in your hearts, sing psalms, hymns, and spiritual songs to God. And whatever you do, in word or deed, do everything in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through him. Husbands and wives, love and support one another, as is proper in the Lord. Avoid any bitterness toward each other. Children, obey your parents in everything, for this is your acceptable duty in the Lord. Parents, do not provoke your children, so they may not become discouraged. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
With you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. After the wise men had left, an angel of the Lord appeared to Joseph in a dream and said, "Get up and take the child and his mother, flee to Egypt, and remain there until I tell you. For Herod is about to search for the child to destroy him." Then Joseph got up, took the child and his mother by night, and went to Egypt, and remained there until the death of Herod. This was to fulfill what had been spoken by the Lord through the prophet, "Out of Egypt I have called my son." When Herod died, an angel of the Lord suddenly appeared in a dream to Joseph in Egypt and said, "Get up, take the child and his mother, and go to the land of Israel. For those who were seeking the child's life are dead." Then Joseph got up and took the child and his mother and went to the land of Israel. But when he heard that Archelaus was ruling over Judea in the place of his father Herod, he was afraid to go there. And after being warned in a dream, they went away to the district of Galilee. There he made his home in a town called Nazareth, so that what was spoken through the prophets might be fulfilled. He will be called a Nazarene. The Gospel of the Lord. In terms of family, mine was a very small family. Like the Holy Family, there was Dad and Mom and myself. And it took 9 years to have me, and I couldn't quite figure that out. So one time after my folks had died, I asked one of my aunts, I said, what's the story here? Why did it take so long to have this blessed event? And she said, well, you were supposed to have had a sister. Never heard of it. Folks never said a word, but I was supposed to have had a sister. And she died, I'm assuming she died at or after birth. And so then things began to make sense. For example, I was often wondering why my mother was so overweening, if you will, caring so much, worried so much about this son of hers. Of course, she had good reason to, but it seemed like it was a little much. I didn't help matters very much. Freshman year, got hit by a truck on my way to school, and you can imagine her reaction to that. I came close to drowning 2 times. She knows about one, but she doesn't know about the other. And I had severe blood poisoning one time when I was in grade school. Those are the main ones, and there are others too. But so you can understand why Mom was the way she was. I would always envy people who had larger families, especially at a time like this at Christmas. It makes for more of a joyous event. Ours were always very quiet, simple events at home. And I tell that to people, you know, from large families. I say, I really envy you because there's so many of you to celebrate these holidays. And many times they would say to me, I wouldn't be so sure of that if I were you. So I have to be careful when I say that, too. But it's what it's about. Family is absolutely the bottom line. That's what it's all about. I mentioned before, we belong to many families, the great human family of Earth, not just this hemisphere, but the other hemisphere as well. We're members of the great faith community we call the Catholic Church, which is, of course, throughout the world. And then we have our own human families from home. Someone said, how would you like to be remembered as a dad or mom or as grandparents? How would you like to be remembered? We can call that a legacy, perhaps. But what is the one or several things you would like them to remember you by or with? People who are joyful, people who are generous, forgiving, always there when needed. Certainly not any of the opposite things, but these are very positive things, wonderful things. I did have a grandfather whom I really didn't know that was my mom's dad, Jacob or Jake Obert. And I'm told he was a very stern man, a man of few words, which isn't exactly the family way to be. He wanted his daughter, my mother, not to marry. And so he would do things like not give her a key to the house, even though she was in her early 20s. And finally, her brother, my uncle Tony, said, give that woman a key. She belongs to this house, give her a key. And finally, my grandfather did. Or when they were dating, they would once in a while come to the house and sit in the living room, and he'd go downstairs and turn off the stove. So they would be a little bit uncomfortable. And then he would sit down with his brother Joe, Jake and Joe, in the backyard. Jake would say to Joe, hi, Joe, and he'd say, hi, Jake. And they'd sit there for half an hour, not say anything, and then Joe got up and said, goodbye, Jake, and he'd say, goodbye, Joe, and that was kind of the way they were. He was a man of few words. That's not what I call a glowing example of a family person, but that's I guess, quite common in those days. Here's a sentence from a homily that a priest gave at the time of his father's funeral. When we talk about legacy or something to be remembered, he said, "Well, here we are, Dad, all gathered together in your honor, filled with great grief, and yet celebrating the love you gave to us that binds us together. We are family, Dad, and you are our legacy." What beautiful, beautiful words in one sentence. And we see that throughout the Old Testament, of course, the whole notion of family, beginning with the first family, Adam and Eve, and their two sons that we know of. They probably had other children, Adam and Cain, or Cain and Abel, I should say. And we know how tragic that was in the jealousy of Cain, who killed his brother Abel. And then as time went on, God continued to promise families blessings and many, many events that would be leading up to the time of our Lord's birth. So if we go then to the time, I'm not going to go through the Old Testament, but if you have Abram and Sarah, for example, they were promised to have a son, and their lives went on and on and on, and they're getting into their upper years, and they didn't have a child yet. And finally, the promise was fulfilled, and they gave birth to Isaac. The word Isaac means laughter, and you can understand why, because people must have smiled a lot when they saw Sarah at her age, pregnant and giving birth to a child. And so they named him Laughter. Here is an heir, and there's a future legacy. And so we look at the gospel today, and again, we see a family, we see faith, and we see a legacy. We have the words of Simeon, who's when they took the child to the temple to be circumcised, he praised God because God allowed him to live up to his old age so that he could hold this person who of great worth and importance in his own hands before he died, before he closed his eyes. And in speaking to his parents, he gave them some hints, some intimations of what role this son would play, his legacy. But he didn't go into great details. But it's important to note it wasn't just happiness and joy, but there would also be sorrow and pain, which we know was true in the life of Mary and in Joseph. And so they had great faith, and they lived with that great faith and trust in God, the promises that God had made. It ended, we know, with their son's death, or Mary's son's death, which was the greatest tragedy, but also led to the greatest act of faith for us, and that, of course, is the resurrection of Jesus, in which each one of us will be taken up, our greatest legacy. Today, we live out our lives with the example of so many family members, our own and others, and friends who lived and died and have left us with the splendid example of their lives. I can't think of any better enumeration of these virtues than what we had in the second reading today, where in Colossians, Paul mentions what these virtues are: compassion, kindness, humility, patience. And if you have a complaint about one another, forgive one another. Pretty well sums up what these virtues are. All that will remain with us then throughout our lives will be the memory of those who've gone before us and the legacy that we will leave after us. And those who follow hopefully can turn in their thoughts and memories of us as people who loved them, who were faithful, and were true family members.
Holy
During the Christmas season, we are aware in a special way of Emmanuel, God with us. With this heightened consciousness that God is right here among us, let us now lift up our prayers.
Our Christmas response is, be born in us, be born in our world. The Holy Family, Jesus, Mary, and Joseph, have been an inspiration that has lasted for centuries. May our church be like this Holy Family, fostering love, building faith, and providing care for our neighbors in need around the world. We pray, be born in us, be born in our world. May the angels' Christmas message, peace on all the earth, inspire world leaders for peace on earth. We pray, be born in us, be born in our world. We pray for all mothers and fathers. They are tasked with the profound responsibility of raising their children in the ways of God in a world obsessed with selfishness and greed. Guide all parents, loving God, as you guided Joseph and Mary on their journey. We pray, be born in us, be born in our world. We pray for married couples. They are called to witness Christ's love in the world, mutually and equally respecting, serving, and loving each other. Encourage them, God of wisdom, in good times and in bad. For this we pray, be born in us, be born in our world. Christ came among us to welcome and heal. May the sick and suffering in our community feel the welcoming presence of God and the healing power of faith. For the sick and all caregivers, we pray. For those signed in our Book of Life, and especially Audrey and Joe Kreiser and Joseph Bittner, for whom this Eucharist is offered, for this we pray. Be born in us, be born in us.
Joy to the world, the Lord hears and answers our prayers. We give thanks and praise to God as we offer these prayers to you, O God, through Christ our Lord, the Messiah, born unto us.
Amen.
Please join us singing our presentation song found on page 28, O Come All Ye Faithful.
Thank you.
creation, for through your goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine, work of human hands. It'll become our spiritual drink. Pray, my sisters, that this Easter Christmas offering of ours may indeed be acceptable to God the Father Almighty. We offer you, Lord, the sacrifice of conciliation, humbly asking that, through the intercession of the Virgin Mary, Mother of God, and Saint Joseph, we may establish families firmly in your grace and in your peace, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in the mystery of the Word made flesh, a new light of your glory has shone upon the eyes of our mind, so that as we recognize in him, God made visible, we may be caught up through him in the love of all things invisible. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness, make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord, Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, he broke it, and he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, eat it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of faith. Do this in memory of me." Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and to minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Jerome, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
And now, united with fellow Christians throughout the world, as we celebrate the birth of our Lord and the feast of the Holy Family, we pray together.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Lord Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. We invite you now to share that peace with one another. Peace be with you. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof. Only say a word and my soul shall be
For those family members who are not able to be with us this evening and are at home, we pray that this Eucharist will be a special occasion for them to join us in faith and in prayer. We invite those taking communion to please come forward. We pray that their new year, like ours, may truly be blessed. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Good evening. This is our announcement for this week. Our Mass for New Year's Day will be Monday at 9 a.m. in the church. As always, for more information about the activities here at St. James, please check out the bulletin, the website, and Facebook.
On behalf of Deacon Sandy and Father Dennis and the rest of the members of the pastoral staff here at St. James Parish, we'd like to extend to you best wishes for a blessed and joyous new year. Let's rise now for our final prayer and blessing. Let us pray. Bring those who refresh with this heavenly sacrament, most merciful Father, to imitate the example of the Holy Family, so that after the trials of this world, we may come to share their company forever, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. This Mass is now ended. Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord.
And as we go forward, please join in singing Joy to the World, found on page 20.